Jonn, shall I dive right in here? It's great to be here. My name is Jerry Robin. As many of you know, I'm the owner of FMPtraining.com. I've been a FileMaker certified developer for about as long as it's been possible to be a certified developer. I've been doing FileMaker development for about 22 years now. Started teaching relational design for Claris back in 1996. So I've presented at DevCon 8 times. I will be presenting again. I will actually be doing a custom menus presentation this year at DevCon, which will be, again, based on the same basic material. A little more about my background. Some of you may know I created the Stairway to 7 class back when FileMaker 7 came out, with the extreme help of Jeff Coffey and Susan Prosser, without whom it would not have happened. Many years ago, I was involved in creating the Scriptology classes back in 98. I was a technical editor for FileMaker Pro 9 and the Missing Manual, also with Jeff and Susan. There's some fabulous FileMaker training CDs that came out in 2004 with FileMaker 7. What are we going to talk about? What are custom menus and learn how to create and use custom menus? Let's talk about basically what custom menus are and why you want to use them. Essentially, they're a user interface tool to enable you to control how your users can actually interact with the database. Probably the single most important thing is that you can prohibit users from doing things that will make bad things happen. For example, things like the delete record command or perhaps the delete all records command. Even though a user's security privilege may entitle them to do things like, say, delete a record, you don't necessarily want to have that on the menu. Of course, the really cool thing is to be able to enable them to do things that are not normally on FileMaker menus. And you can see one of the really cool things here is in this particular menu we've changed the words so that instead of using a generic term like record, which a user may or may not even understand, we use a word like contact, which actually explicitly makes sense to the user in the context that they are currently in. Before you make any changes to this menu set, you need to realize that because you can't edit or duplicate the standard FileMaker menus, if you edit or duplicate the custom menu set, you now no longer have a clean, original set to work with. So the first thing I always recommend before you start doing anything with custom menus is duplicate custom menu set 1 and give it the lovely name of custom menu set 1 copy. Now you can mess around with that all you want, and you can always go back and get a fresh template, essentially, anytime you need it. Now, an important point, and I get asked this every time I teach this seminar, is if you remove the delete record command, for example, what impact does that have on the user's ability to run a scripted delete activity? And the answer is, doesn't affect it at all. All it does is remove it from the menu. Whether or not a user can actually delete a record is based on their privileges in their accounts and privileges, okay? It's important to note that if you have, for some reason, decided to assign a command key to one of your scripts, to one of your custom menu items, and you've decided to use command 1 through command 0, that will in fact not override this. The scripts menu will win. One question that I frequently get in the seminars is there any way to create a menu item, a custom menu item, and then have it show as grayed out under certain circumstances? And as far as I can determine, the only way to do that is to attach it to a behavior that the user is not allowed to perform. So that is actually a way of showing somebody something but not letting them use it, if that's your idea of a good time. Another thing you can do, we can go back and set our default back to standard. But in this particular layout, we can go to layout setup and we can specify use contact menus as the default for this layout, or as the menu set for this layout. So then, if I switch to another layout, you see it switches back to my standard menus. But when I switch here, it automatically switches to my contact menu set. And if you're using scripted navigation, or if you're using script triggers, layout-based script triggers, then what you can do is, rather than assigning a menu set to the layout, you can instead simply have a script trigger attached to that layout, which runs a script, because now you've got even more control. When you go in here, everything's got the specify calculation dialog box available to it, okay? Which means you don't have to be stuck with some hard-coded value. The default enabling for the close command, we specifically select the close command, not only is it on the file menu normally, but also it's triggered by clicking the close box. Okay? So what we've done here is we've said that anytime you actually activate the close command, which right now is on this menu, okay, I've actually added it to this edit menu, okay? Anytime you activate what would normally trigger the close command, instead of just closing the window, actually run this script.
Thank you, Jerry. Thank you so much, Jerry.
Thanks, Jerry.